I have been a strong Christian for over 20 years. But when I got touched by the call of God and opened my heart up to revival, it totally transformed me into a different person. And I believe that there's another outpouring thing. Not all of the church yet in that revival, but a lot of the people in the church rejected that because there were a lot of controversial things that were happening, a lot of foolish manifestations. But then again, I'll say that the Lord uses the foolish things to conform to us. And I got touched radically by it, and I got in it, and I've been a holy roller, I've rolled on the floor, and I've laughed, I've got into the holy laughter, I've gotten drunk from the Holy Spirit, and that's all fun.
You know, it really is. It's awesome to let go and to really let God have control.
Yeah.
And what's so great about the church is our next guest. I actually rolled around at this place several times and been so drunk in the Spirit of God, I wouldn't even say.
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of people can't understand it. So what I would say is, for those who can't understand it, don't knock it for yourself.
Yeah.
God wants to touch you. God wants to love you. You know? And so it's one I went to revival. True revival.
Mm-hmm.
True revival is about to hit my way. I don't think I'm any way.
Yeah.
You know, the last revival was by the way, true revival was called. I had two forms of it, one that was in Pentecost, but also the Toronto 1600 revival took place. And we saw, you know, pastors coming to that thing that were in such a religious place, and I'll say that they went and got out of it. Good. So we're about to step into our next segment, bring our next guest on here shortly. We've got about 10 seconds before we're moving into this thing, and you know, I'll tell you, I'm excited about what's going on. You know, if any of you have questions, I'll just take an email over, or maybe shoot us an email and forward it over to you, or something like that. Okay. So get your questions for Rich. We welcome you to see us an email. And right. Coming up on our next segment, right now. I'll tell you what, that was incredible. That really inspired me that. Before this, you know, I had some questions on the trip. I wasn't 100% sure, but I'll tell you one thing. God has stirred my spirit in a way that I can't comprehend what He's seen in the most of you. And to let go and to let God and to allow the Holy Spirit to minister to you through the world and to take what He's given, you know, given these other spirits. That's when we can freely begin to see the ministry. Incredible. My next guest is a mighty man of God that I look up to as well. I really received a lot of healing for you as well. My next Buck Eaton. Welcome back to thank you. Good to be back. It's awesome to have you here. You know, it's incredible kind of moving from the chills to the Father's heart. But there's a lot of love in the Father even bringing this forth and such moments.
Absolutely. You know, I've known Rich for a long time. And I remember in 1999, gold was about 235,000 ounces, and oil was $9.5. And the chicken community was involved. So I had a no fear of love, but perfect love casts out fear. We love because it's first love. And this is God's word. This is really God's word. For the mercy of love. The Father's love. He is a tool of the faculty of Jesus Christ. He learned to get this. The fear in our weakness, the deep love of Jesus Christ is alive. And even on our time, within the Lord Jesus Christ, we can have a good love of Jesus Christ. I really wish to thank you. But we can, like I've heard you say something, we are sitting here nothing to do. So we're just such a good power for our love and sacrifice. And, you know, Matthew 10, 28 and 30 talk about this. And that fear means the fear of God. We're the fear of God. And that, the fear of the Lord is fear. It had a respect and an awe for who he is. But he really wanted to stay there, because he knows the soul of every soul. And that he counts the hair on our head. He says, do not sleep. Because he knows every, and that's a compassionate statement. So we have to be in a great effect. We have to walk in a love relationship with him. And he loves us in the verses. And when you count the hairs on our head, it's about to get us out of murder. He lives in the whole body, and there's every detail of it. That's his love for us. He knows us to the very detail of the number of our hairs on our head, and the mother that's in the air about the body, about the heavenly Father and the Son of God. That's the detail you see across the head of the head, and the end of the head, and that's really incredible. You know, listen, you guys are talking about it. We're in a shaky place. But you know what? This is a sick world of sick. And Hebrews, the writer of Hebrews in chapter 4, talks about now dying, and my son, and when God descended upon my son, I was sick and taken by it. But even Moses was in the grave, and he was afraid. And the spirit of God said, you talk to him, you don't want to talk to him. But we've been brought to him in the cross, which will be unshakable kingdom. We're no longer part of the shaky stuff. We are part of the unshakable kingdom. And let me read that in Hebrews, actually, in my Hebrews 12, this is really a revelation to me. And the Lord bless it to you. In verse 21, it says, if they travel with a Christ, that most of them are full of fear and sympathy, but you have come to Mount Zion. Think of your going to Mount Zion, but you have come to. We have come to Mount Zion, to the city of the living God, heavenly Jerusalem, and the mighty of kingdom, to the general assembly, and the church of the firstborn, who are enrolled in heaven, to God, the judge of all, and to the spirit of the righteous and the perfect, and to Jesus, the mediator of the new covenant, and to come to the simple blood which speaks before the blood of people. So this is saying we have come to this place. This sounds like heaven. We have come to the kingdom of God. We have been brought into the kingdom even now. And he says down in verse 27, it says, yet once more the nature removing of those things which can be taken as a created thing, so that those things which cannot be taken may remain. So we live in the shaking of goodness. But we're a part of an unshakable kingdom. And we are wrapped in the blood of our God. There is nothing to speak. The truth comes from the Lord. That's the confusion in the love of the pastor. We can love on Him. We can rest in Him. Mm-hmm. And the Lord.
You know, Rich was talking about the oil and the wine. And it really was funny because it hit me when I was up on the whiteboard right now, but I really trying to prepare for this, and we read the Word of God, and the Holy Spirit will be so very comfortable, and so the Lord becomes very hungry for us, and we need to look at it, and that really stuck out to me, the oil in the Lord. That's the oil of the Lord. You know, and we thought, I really didn't take down the mountain, but I know it has something to do with it, and I said, you know, I'll do the same. We get here tonight, and it just seems like the oil in the mountain. To the God of his kingdom. It's freedom. It's freedom that's coming to each other. You know, we're at a point right now where our second account may look like they're nothing. So, right now, maybe our part is what we suggest, and maybe it's going to take care of everything. What's that? It's just going to look like a cause in the second account. Someone goes hungry, God's never let anyone know.
Well, you know, a couple years ago, they broke down. And I believe we have come to this is how much the Lord is working on the Lord. It is God. I believe you're such a man. I believe you're such a man. It's a prayer that I'm talking about. And I believe that when you walk into a meeting, that's where your love is supposed to be. You're just going to walk directly into